गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट अवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक दैट इज द टाइप्स ऑफ प्रोपेंसिटी टू सेव, दैट इज द मार्जिनल प्रोपेंसिटी टू सेव, इट मींस MPS. इट रेफर्स टू द रेशियो ऑफ चेंज, दैट इज डिनोटेड चेंज, इट मींस द डेल्टा चेंज इन सेविंग एंड चेंज इन टोटल इनकम, दैट इज द चेंज इन सेविंग एंड चेंज इन टोटल इनकम. व्हेन वी सीन दैट APS, APS, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय द APS? APS, इट मींस इट रेफर्स टू द not the change in, that is the ratio of the saving and national income. And what is the MPS? Marginal always stand for the change, fine. So MPS, marginal propensity to save, it refers to the ratio of change in saving to change in national income, clear? So total national income. So what is the formula of MPS? MPS equal to delta S upon delta Y. Delta S, it means change in saving, and delta Y, it means change in total income. Here schedule is given. MPS schedule is income rupees in crores, saving rupees in crores, and all these things in rupees in crores only. Same measurement, fine. So income, when the income level is zero, your saving is minus 40. We already seen at that saving function also, S equal to function of Y. So when the income level is zero, your saving is minus 40. It means this is this that level on you are in the dissaving for. Dissaving, it means there is no change, because change ke liye comparison data chahiye. So previous no data is there. So no change in delta Y, no change in delta S and delta Y. So no change in the MPS. Now your income will be increased by 100 rupees. It means now your income is 100 rupees in crores. So saving is minus 20. It means your total consumption is minus 120. So 100 rupees your income, your consumption is 120. So that is again the minus 20. It means you are using the your previous year savings of 20 rupees in crores. So again the 20 minus 20, it means it shows the this saving aspect. Now what is the change? So minus 40 and minus 20, how many change are there? That is 20 rupees change are there. And again income 100 minus 0, it means 100 rupees income ka change dikh raha hai. So what is the MPS? MPS equal to delta S upon delta Y. So delta S here 20, so 20 upon 100, it should be the 0.20. Now again your income will be increased by 100. It means now your income is 200 rupees. So your saving is 0. It means whatever you earn something, and if your income is 200, your consumption expenditure is also 200. So no saving is there. So at that point, there is the 20 rupees saving, because 0 minus 20 minus 20. It means suppose when your perception is the that. Fine. So 0 plus 20. It means that change should be in 20. So that is change. Again the saving change is the 20. That is delta S. Now 100, because 200 minus 100, again 100. So MPS, what is the formula? Delta S upon delta Y. It means 20 upon 100, again 0.20. Now again your income will be increased by 100 rupees. So pehle kitni thi? 200. Now increase by 100, it means now your income will be 300 rupees. So your income will be 300, your saving is 20. So that is your assumption. You just saved income 20 rupees. It means 280 rupees your consumption expenditure. So 20 rupees your saving. So again find out delta S. So 20 minus 0, it means 20. Delta Y, so 300 minus 200, it means 100. Now MPS equal to delta S upon delta Y. So 20 upon 100 again becomes a 0.20. It means your income level is changed in the 100 and your saving function changes with the 20 rupees. So delta S remain same in 20 rupees and delta Y also same in 100 rupees. So MPS also becomes the same criteria, 0.20. Now seen the graph also, that is the Y axis. We shown the Y axis, that is the saving in rupees in crores. And on the X axis, income rupees in crores. This is the this saving criteria. We already seen when we are talking about the APS, fine. This is the this saving criteria. Now in economics already 100 times I told you, this type of line denoted by the change. Fine, plotted line denoted by the change. अगर हमको economics में कोई change दिखाना है तो we just put the line like the plotted line. Clear? This is the economics funda. So this is the original line. This one is, and this is the B point. And what, this is the B point, it means this is the APS only. But we are talking about the change between delta S and delta Y. So whatever change, yahan jo change hoga, that is called the saving. Saving change, it means delta S. So this change called the delta S, this called. So this is the delta S, it is denoted by the PR or RP, whatever, right? And this change is denoted by the Y1 to Y2. It means this is your change Y1 to Y2 and this change is called the income change. It means change in income. So this is your change in, this change is called the delta S and this change is called the delta Y. Clear? Now this is your MPS. MPS equal to delta S upon delta Y. This is the common point. It means PR upon Y1 upon Y2. Because PR denoted by delta S and Y1, Y2 denoted by the delta Y. This is the graph representations of the MPS. Some important points about the MPS we had just discussed. Now only. So MPS point, if the entire additional income is saved. Entire additional income is saved. Suppose 100 rupees ka additional income hua hai, 100 rupees aap save karte ho, at that point no consumption expenditure, fine, no consumption expenditure, it means your delta C becomes a zero and your MPS becomes the one. So that is the one point, when the delta C equal to zero, your MPS equal to one. Because entire sum of income, it means additional income, jitna bhi additional income hota hai, aap agar wo save kar lete ho, suppose your additional income is 100 and your saving is also 100, so 100 upon 100 becomes the 1. So when your delta C, it means your consumption expenditure 0, kab hoga consumption expenditure 0? When you saved entire additional income. So your consumption expenditure delta C becomes 0, at that point your MPS becomes the 1. Clear? Now the second point, however, if entire additional income is consumed, suppose second point, entire income becomes the consumed, so it means your delta S becomes the 0. You are saving nothing because jitna bhi additional income hua hai, you just consumption, you used as a consumption expenditure. At that point, your MPS becomes a zero. Because what is the formula of MPS? Delta S upon delta Y. So suppose this is zero and this is 100. So your answer should be zero. Clear? So at that point, these are the two important points about the MPS. If, again I am repeating two points. First, if the additional income, entire additional income saved, at that point delta C becomes 0 and MPS is 1. When entire additional income will be consumed, at that point delta S equal to 0 and your MPS becomes a 0. Clear? This is the two important point aspect about the MPS. Fine? Now just basically, just recall the APS and MPS. What is the formula of APS? S upon Y. What is the formula of MPS? Delta S upon delta Y. What is the value less than 0? So APS can be less than 0 when there are the dissaving. And MPS can never be less than 0 as the change of saving never be negative. These are the very important criteria about the APS and MPS. APS 0 ho sakta hai because the reason of dissaving. But MPS never be less than 0. Kyunki that is next to impossible ki consumption hua hi na ho. Theek hai? So in next period we just discuss about the relationship between APS and MPS. That's all for today. Have a nice day. Thank you and have a nice day.